of time in my para camper and para hauling trailer. Listen to a little Eddie Van Halen. He just died 2 days ago. I'm losing too many of them guys lately. John Prine. A lot more. Tom Petty. It's pretty sad. Getting back to my para trailer here. Check it out. Thought I'd do a little tour on this thing today and show you a few things in here. For one thing, here is my little wind dummy. Keep him handy. Shoot him up in the sky and just see conditions. How smooth it is. Helmet bag. Got some traction kites here I've had for quite a while. And this is actually an Ozone Little Devil. It's a large one. This is the medium one from Rad Sales. And that's a small Rad Sale. I probably use this medium one more than anything. I have a traction board, mountain board, that I use to fall on my ass with. So I only do that on the beach where the sand is kind of soft. My spare prop box, which you just saw me playing. My DX6i controller for my wind dummy here. My helmet bag. Chase Cam. He's got all kinds of duct tape on him anymore. Tabs all broken, flies crooked. They don't do very good when they hit the prop. Spare exhaust. Tripod. Fuel filters, tools, miscellaneous junk. Yeah, a teepee too. What do I got? A teepee in my flying trailer? Well, it's storage. Mouse free. My wings, two of them here. Ozone and a Gen glider. My one socks. Had this one for a long time. Ozone one sock. These guys are all fairly new. Little four-wheeler flags. That's my windsock. I bought that in 87 from the Tlingit Indian tribe up in Sitka, Alaska. Sent it down, gave it to her daughter for her birthday. Then on her 18th birthday, she flew out of the nest so fast, left everything, and I got to keep the windsock. So here it is. And well, she came back and she bought me this one for my birthday. And I don't know how many years old this is, but it hasn't been holding up very good. It's been through a few battles, but she still flies. Paperwork for my ultralight, logbooks, licenses, all that legal stuff. Sectional charts for my local area where I'm flying. Those are handy to have. My toy box for my trike here. The helmets and everything for it. And all other little special things. Here's my Airborne Redback trike. Two-seater. 503. Goes about 60 miles an hour. Got a BRS on the back. Tundra gear. It's good for off field. The 115 mini plane. That mini plane is over 20 years old. Over 300 hours on the engine. Had a top end done on the engine, or actually just the top connecting rod, the piston bearing changed out in it, and really not much else. Just putting carburetors on it once in a while. I went ready to fly the other night and both of these straps were hanging down. Never had that happen. I tied them up behind the seat. They would have gone in the prop probably on each side, but they go up to your shoulder strap here and link into that. I don't know how they came out. That's puzzling. Lots of storage on top. I've used this trailer for several configurations. One year we traveled all around the country and we hauled our little Hyundai car in here. And I had this shelf come on clear out to here with the hood of the car underneath of it. And you might ask, well, how'd you get in and out of the car then? Because the doors were just right up against the sides. Well, that was the wife's job. She's a little bit more curvy than I am and can bend around sharper objects. And she'd actually go out between the seats and into the back seat, pull it out and through a little hatch door in the trunk and out through the trunk and out the back door. Same way getting in. But we got it done. Driving around is nice to have a little car when you had a motorhome hooked up. Van Halen. I've been rocking with them ever since I was a teenager. And I'm like 63 years old right now. Back view of my trailer here. Keep all the gas back here. Water, gunny sacks in case we have a fire. Back side of the trike. Here. I've got a roller system for the top, and it's not in here right now. I'll show you that, but it fits up on that front top rack. It's a roller bar, and I get the wing, prop it up like that, get it on the roller bar. Someone out here to push on it, and I end up crawling around, going up this ladder I made for the trailer here, getting up there, pulling the wing all the way down and getting it cinched on. Actually, I'm wrong. We would do the wing from the back. Yep, roll it right up from the back. I haven't done that in a long time. I need a couple people when I do it. It's usually when I go to a fly-in or something, which I really haven't been doing lately. But here's the wing. It's hard enough getting it on top of this rig. I got a hurt shoulder from last night getting it up there. Then the last time I lost my grip, it came down and hit me in the side of the face. Bruised my cheek up. With a couple people, it rides up there real nice. Because the trailer is only a 14 footer. So you need 20 feet to get a wing inside. But yeah, the trailer. It's going to be stormy the next few days. A lot of rain coming in tonight. I've been leaving my trailer at the flying field. I brought it home yesterday just to clean it out and rearrange it. Seems like when I fly, by the time I land, I gotta tear this thing down and get it all put away, and it's just totally dark, and the trailer just got to be a big mess in here. Oh, here's one of my Adele socks. Went down. Wings have changed. Well, here's another Adele streamer from the old days. Right there. I owned three different Adele gliders, one custom sail glider. Now I got an Ozone glider. Oh, I completely forgot about my Gen paraglider. Flew that thing for almost 20 years. But now I just use it for kiting. It still flies though, but I think it's out of trim. In fact, I know it's out of trim. Okay, I think that about wraps up the trailer. Did some custom paint jobs in there, Jerry did. stars on the ceiling, green on the sides, and brown on the bottom. I've owned this trailer now for, I'd say, about 20 years now too. It's been a great trailer. The first trip in it, we hooked it behind our Durango, pulled it down, and right here I had a table and sink, a camp stove sat there. We had a rafting little porta potty out and a tent outside. And we lived in this trailer for 45 days. We went down south on a flying trip. We was at the Salton Sea, out of Quartzsite, Arizona, Monument Valley, San Diego, California. Traveled around all the hot spots. And it worked out good. We would get a motel room every few days and really get cleaned up, but we made do out in the desert too with this. Now we have another trailer. I don't have the motorhome anymore, so it kind of just sits around the storage in my flying trailer now. It's what it meant to be. And how many of these paracampers do you see with an awning on a cargo trailer? That was an option we put on when we bought it. So the window was an option right there. The awning was an option. It's about 15 years old and still the same awning. It's funny, when we bought our motorhome after we bought this trailer, the awning on the motorhome was the exact same pattern as this. The colors, everything. It was a perfect match. And our motorhome was a diamond ice cutter like this was, with the blue stripes on it. And we had this custom rack put on top. But like I said, I built the ladder for the side and mounted it, and the catwalk that's zip tied on top, so I can crawl around on that and tie down my glider. Or gliders. And we had these special flow through vents put in. That's about it. This trailer is about 15 years old, and when we bought it, we paid about $5,400 for it. I'd like to know what it costs now. It'd be around $8,000 for this thing.